Their next engineered crisis will be on a scale never before seen in modern times. Shortages and empty shelves will spread fear and panic across the land. The insiders have discovered that they must control two things to seize total power. Phase one is a one-world currency, which we are currently being prepared to accept. Phase two of their insidious plan is complete control of our food supplies. Go to www.foodshortageusa.com for the details. That's www.foodshortageusa.com to learn how to prepare for the unthinkable. Don't wait for empty shelves. Learn how to make your own survival foods for pennies on the dollar. Go to foodshortageusa.com or call 877-327-0365. That's 877-327-0365.
When they play Hail to the Chief, they point the cannon at you. Think about that.
Some folks are born.
Name the cannons of the crowd. In the 1950s, they brought in the symbol of fascism into the U.S. Senate, the bundle of sticks with the hatchets on the top, the symbol of Benito Mussolini, of Adolf Hitler, of Julius Caesar. They arrogantly are setting up a world government, a tyranny in front of you. And they have the nerve to say it doesn't exist. When you say you don't want to be part of it. Okay, this is a short segment, Barry, but we're coming back in a long one. Before you got here today, I was thinking, man, what are we going to talk about? There is so much that you've done, so much that's gone on. Recap a little bit about yourself, the things you've witnessed, and some of the things you're doing, some of the new stings you're working on, and your overall mission.
Well, to repeat, our overall mission is to get prisoners, the nonviolent drug prisoners, out. We really have a heart for them. And we've learned activism can get us there. I was one of our nation's top drug enforcement officers for 8 years. And I quit being a drug cop. And over the last 2 years, I've produced two films, Traffic Stops Volume 1 and Never Get Raided Volume 2. And they are instructional films that teach how to counter DEA's or task force's measures against citizens to place them in jail for marijuana. Coming off of that success, my wife and I recently set a trap for crooked cops out in Odessa, and they fell into that trap, and we've got them on camera in an illegal raid. We just learned the Texas Rangers are coming in to investigate the police corruption, which is what we called for, so we're making some progress there. We just got back from Hollywood. We can talk about that. And I'm running for office. We want to announce that as well. So there's a lot going on.
Well, let's do that.
Exactly what you want to...
No, I mean, that's great. Let's get into those subjects next. First off, Texas Rangers. I'm not saying they're perfect, but we've had some former Texas Rangers. The guy was an awesome police officer when he went up the tower and shot the bad guy back in the 60s, Whitman, who was shooting everybody. And I did find it was the Texas Rangers. Remember, 2 years ago, it turned out the state police and the Texas Rangers had found out about the Texas Youth Commission raping all these kids.
We were talking about that on the way up here.
And it was the Texas Rangers trying to stop it, and we're told stop. Mm-hmm. And the head of the DPS just got removed, and I have it from back channels directly. He was removed because he was going after the state officials involved with these kids. And so I guess the Texas Rangers seem to be pretty good.
Well, we talked about, well, there's corruption in all of law enforcement, but from what I've seen so far, the Texas Rangers do turn in an objective report. They're good at investigating, and they try to keep emotions out of it. And hopefully that's what we get in this case. But
they're now going after the police that you stung.
Right, right. But what's interesting is you mentioned those kids getting raped in the prison down there in our Texas.
Most of them are marijuana.
Yeah, exactly. And the Texas Rangers, I think, reported 40-some-odd cases of sexual abuse. Do you remember the
and
number?
And then it turned out it was all over thousands.
Yeah, and not one person was arrested. Well, that I want to make it. I'm running for Attorney General of the state of Texas. You do not have to be an attorney to run for attorney general. And I really am good in court and being an attorney anyway, but that's going to be one of my first cases. I want to reopen that can of worms on our youth in Texas.
Well, the Youth Commission, they just covered it all up.
Well, I know, and that's wrong. If we had a strong attorney general in there, he would go in and prosecute those people. If you can't take care of the youth of our country, even the ones that are in jail, then you have nothing to live for. Our prisoners are
are forgotten. The kids that are in prison right now are forgotten. And we need to wake up and go back and get our children. It's craziness what they're doing to our people in prison.
Yeah. Well, the one time I was in jail as a juvenile, because I got in a fight, beat the guy up real bad, even though, once it went to court, it was no, there's witnesses, Alex was attacked first, but since the guy went to the hospital, I went to jail when the cops got there. And they took me to Terrell, because I was in Rockwall, but they took me to the juvenile jail in Terrell. I'm up on top of the courthouse, and it was a Friday, so they put me, I didn't go to court in the Rockwall till, I don't want to get into these stories, but the point is, I've told it before, until Monday. And by Sunday morning, I was just sitting in there, doing nothing, getting out 1 hour a day watching TV. And I said, hey, I notice other people are taking showers. Can I take a shower? And this big, fat pedophile, who was one of the jail guards there in Terrell, and I was, pretty handsome, I guess, when I was like, 14 years old or whatever.
Well, I think you're still handsome.
No, I'm big fat ass now. But anyways, the point is, he takes me into the shower. It's like a one-room shower. And he says, oh, you look pretty good. Let's have some. And I said, listen, you think you're going to get away from this? I assure you, my family's going to destroy you. And because I was already, well-spoken then, and the guy kind of went, come on, you little bastard, you don't get a shower, you can stink. So, that's America. Mm-hmm. The pedophiles all know where to go rape kids.
Absolutely. And we want to get that stopped, and we're going to. Whatever activism it takes, we're going to keep setting up stings to bust these crooked cops. We're not stopping. In fact, I announced it last time. Within a couple months, we're going to bust another cop. Then we'll move to another town and bust another cop.
Well, listen, you've got a lot of courage, and it's even dangerous being involved with you, but I'm throwing in with you to get you this show to help you because, again, I was talking about the subject. You just bring it up. I didn't even know you were on the same page.
We're on the march. The Empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
More than 700 chemicals have been found in our drinking water. And did you know that you have greater exposure to these chemicals while taking hot showers than when drinking the water? That's because many chemicals are inhaled when they evaporate and others are absorbed into the skin. The KDF Dual Media Shower Filter works with both hot and cold water, and it's designed to reduce chlorine, lead, mercury, and iron, and it inhibits the growth of bacteria, mold, algae, and fungus. The KDF Dual Media Shower Filter typically lasts 10,000 gallons or 1 year, whichever comes first. Hospitals, restaurants, and water treatment facilities use this media to reduce chlorine, iron, heavy metals, and bacteria. What about you? Order your KDF Shower Filter normally, $49 for our special price of only $39.99 with free shipping. Call the Berkey Guy and order now by calling 1-877-886-3653. That's 1-877-886-3653. Or simply click on the banner at GCNLive.com to order online now.
A day unlike any other in the long course of American history, a terrorist act of war against this country.
The enemy struck America on September 11th. But who is the enemy?
Bin Laden.
This is his M.O.
We have to look to the Middle East. We have to look to Osama bin Laden.
Fabled Enemies is the first 9/11 film to take a close look at the terrorist ties to intelligence networks inside the United States.
Some U.S. investigators believe that there are Israelis again very much engaged in spying in and on the U.S.
I'm aware that some Israeli citizens have been detained.
Bin Laden's connections to the CIA, the hijackers' ties to the FBI, the Saudi Arabian connection, the Israeli intelligence network, warnings and war games, the shadow government, and much, much more. Fabled Enemies. Get the DVD at Infowars.com or see it in super high quality, along with hundreds of other titles at PrisonPlanet.tv.
Either you are with us or you are with the terrorists.
Silver is mankind's oldest natural antibiotic. This very special mineral has been used for centuries by most cultures throughout the world. Utopia, Texas is home to a small but mighty supplement company called Utopia Silver, who offers colloidal products produced in distilled water without use of animal protein, nitrates, or saline solutions. Because our colloidal silver is made up of nano-sized particles, it can be better utilized at the cellular level, and germs can't mutate to be resistant like they can to modern-day antibiotics. Utopia Silver has a broad range of health supplements, including colloidal silver, gold, and copper, with a money-back guarantee on the colloidal products we produce. For 4 years, Utopia Silver has been fighting in the Texas courts against agencies that would steal our God-given rights of health care and freedom of speech. Visit us today at utopiasilver.com. That's U-T-O-P-I-A, silver.com. Or call 888-213-4338, 888-213-4338, and help us win this battle.
Thank you.
wish a buck was still silver. It was back when the country was strong. Back before Elvis and before the Vietnam War came along. Before the Beatles and yesterday.